Okay, we'll move into the commissioner reports. I want to thank Stephanie for putting this meeting together and our CTO meeting. We had one of our employees that normally does it had an emergency, and Stephanie stepped in and got everything organized. And, well, she'd say it was disorganized, but she did a good job, so I want to thank Stephanie. And I want to thank John and all of his people. All the work that you and your crew do. And Stephen, thank you for all that you do. Food is great. It has been, always will be, so we really appreciate it. And the friends of the railroad. I don't know what we would do without you guys. It's just tremendous, the job that you guys do for us, and we really, really appreciate all you do for us. I've been the chairman for a year. It's been interesting. It didn't take up much of my time.
That's what I promised you.
That's what you promised me.
You can keep the job if you like it so well.
And I just appreciate all the input that I get from everybody. People that I talk to, I give them my card. Anybody that comes in the restaurant or that I see on the street or when I'm down at the train station, and I tell them, here's my email address, send me a letter. Tell me the pluses and the minuses. That's how we get better. We want to hear it all, and we've had quite a bit of feedback this year. And
mostly positive.
Mostly positive, and some really good suggestions on how to make it better. Really never got anything negative, so it was, the feedback has been good from the people that I've polled. And that's just goes to right back to John and his crew and the job that they've done this year. So thanks, John. Really appreciate it.
Can I mention one thing?
One thing.
We would be remiss in not noting the contribution, in many cases above and beyond the call of duty, that was made by Mountain View Tours, our motor coach operator, and by our representatives here, particularly Roger, who in many cases helped tremendously in making sure that we had coaches in the right place and supporting the Cinder Bear Experience product. It really has been a team effort, and that team effort has included contractors, in particular Toltec Gorge Catering and Mountain View Tours, to help make this a successful season. What we need to remember with regard to our public is they don't see any lines between us. The food service, the bus, it's all us. And I really appreciate the effort that both of you major contractors made to make this a successful year. That's all.
Yeah, thanks, Roger. And tell Greg thanks. It is a team effort, so thanks. And that's all I have. We'll go to the vice chairman report. Mr. Love.
In the interest of your timing requirements, I don't have anything. I'll cover the specific items under new business.
Okay. Randy?
Just a couple of things. The revenues for the state of New Mexico appear to be very strong. The last estimate I heard was that the general fund could be as much as $265 million ahead with new money over last year. So I think that if we need to put together an ask for Senator Martinez and Representative Rodella, in addition to our capital ask that we've gone for. I think we made a mistake on our capital ask by not asking for more than we perhaps needed to make up for some of what we didn't get last year. So we'll find out this afternoon, but I think it's too late to modify our ask from the capital side, which is the part that flows to the LFC. My proposal would be that we had looked at a couple of capital things, but would be to discuss with both Senator Martinez and Representative Rodella the idea of trying to find an additional $300,000 for track, because during the CTO meeting we found out that we're going to if we get fully funded from both New Mexico and Colorado, we're going to be short in excess of $300,000 for what our needs are next year. We can maintain the track, but there's no money to buy ballast, and there's no money to buy ties. So my thinking would be to ask them for $300,000 specifically for ballast and ties. And then it appears that we're going to be, again, because we didn't get funding last year, we're going to be about $150,000 short on our car renovation projects that we need for this season. So again, my thought would be to ask for the 150. The hard part is I don't think we'd need that in more of emergency funding, because we'd really need it this year. And I don't know if they're able to do that. It's possible. And if not, we could use maybe other funds and then try to work on a reimbursement program. Because again, it would be out of general fund as opposed to capital dollars. Capital dollars have to be reimbursement in the same year. But I think with general fund, we might be able to. So my thought is to ask them for a total of $450,000 between the two, with Senator Martinez taking on about 300 of that, and Representative Rodella taking on 150, along with a couple of other legislators that are very positive. So would that be okay with the commission? I'm not making it as a motion, but give me feedback, because I don't want to ask for something. We didn't have it as an agenda item, so I thought we ought to at least discuss it a little bit.
It's from my point of view, it makes very good sense, and it gives us the ability to protect ongoing programs that are funded but perhaps not at the top of the priority list. So the absence of New Mexico capital funding this year, I think, has pretty severe implications throughout the railroad, and they will last longer than just 1 year. So anything that you can do through your efforts this afternoon and ongoing to rectify the situation, even if it's piecemeal, are very, very welcome. John and I had a conversation last night about this very subject, one of the specifics of this subject, and it is clear to me that the railroad, at least, is taking every opportunity it can find to address the need to do two things. One is to continue the work on our equipment that needs to happen every winter, and two, to make sure, and this is pretty important to us, that we employ those people who work on these on this equipment throughout the winter, so that they are not only given a job, but more importantly, from our selfish point of view, that they are available next year when we need them in the summer. So, I mean, there are a lot of big ramifications that go on, and we're addressing that, but it would certainly be really, really helpful if your ask was presented, and successfully so.
So, John, if I could have you prepare two documents for me, one would justify the $300,000 and another would be the $150,000, and particularly on the $150,000 side, as detailed as we can, and I'd ask him and anybody else who knows, particularly Representative Rodella well, that we take this to her. I have a strong relationship with the senator, but my relationship with Representative Rodella is not quite as strong. So help there would be particularly useful, but help with the senator would be great too, those who know the senator. But I think there's a real opportunity with $260 million of extra money, new money, the funding that will be available to the individual legislators, which is unique to New Mexico by comparison to Colorado, will be significantly increased. And so it could be really, really strong. That's it, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Pete?
I'll keep it short. One, I was very impressed with the no reportables. Nice job. to John and everybody on the railroad. That's a very difficult feat to attain, and that was very well done. Secondly, again, just seconding Randy's comments on George. George came into a very difficult situation on the financials left by, and I think we've done a nice job on that, and I appreciate his work on getting us financials in a more timely manner, and a lot of different asks there, and he's been responding well, and it's looking better and better every day. And thank you, Mr. Chairman, for being a chairman.
Thank you.
Job well done. So that's it for the treasurer's report.
Okay, thank you, Pete. Tim, friends of the Coopers and Toltecs Scenic Railroad.